at that.
There's some nice ones there. Nice ones.
We're moving to New Zealand, mate.
Here we are with another instalment of a full episode, all free at ultimatefishing.tv, and it is kingfish madness with a couple of Aussie fishos, Lee Rayner and Paul Worsling, out on the Hauraki Gulf in New Zealand. And this was just a mad session, fishing with light tackle for kingfish.
Mate, there's some highs in your life. You're about to have your first kid. I'm about to get married to Rach. But
this is better than both of those things.
Sorry, Dale. The kingy, it's up there.
It's great looking back at this, and the action and even the techniques are all still relevant today. So while we're on our way out here today to film some new stuff, enjoy this blast from the past right here, and it's all free at ultimatefishing.tv. This week on The Ultimate Fishing Show, we're joined by Australian fishing personalities Paul Worsling and Lee Rayner for a trip to Great Barrier Island. But en route to our destination, we're run into a shoal of yellowtail kingfish feeding on the surface. So what had started out as a quick stop has turned into a full-on fishing session. New Zealand is home to the largest yellowtail kingfish in the world, with fish up to 120 pounds. These fish, pound for pound, are amongst the toughest fish in the ocean. And while I'm eager to show our Australian guests some of the place where these big kingfish reside, I'm struggling to convince them that it can get any better than what we are currently experiencing right on the doorstep of Auckland City.
Well, this here is an excellent example of what's down there. I've just pulled up, I said to the guys, drop your jigs because 10 metres down, there's a bunch of kingfish. And this is what this dark red stuff is here. A lot of this is, some of this is noise, bait fish, krill and stuff that's in this top layer of warm water. Down here, that is a big pack of snapper. That's where they're all hitting us. About 20 metres off the bottom, and these will be individual little pockets of fish. The guys have dropped, and I think if we spin the camera around, they might have just hooked up already.
Was that very far down?
No.
10 metres?
Oh, just cast out, yeah.
Got the sea anchor out?
No.
Hang on. Yeah, they look like they're all down about 10 metres, the ones I can see.
There you go. Now, pretty much everything seems to be working that we've been throwing at these fish. I'm going to a jig, mainly because, well, everything else is working. They're taking the plastics. There's no reason why we shouldn't be able to crank up a jig. Paul's gone to a popper. Hopefully we'll get some nice surface action, and there's some nice fish just following his popper, but we'll get to that in a moment. What I want to point out is our bait board. All morning we must have caught 40 fish already. Not a lot of mess on the bait board. It's all rubber and metal jigs. It's a great way to fish.
There he is, there he is. Eat it.
You're going to get it.
Eat it.
Oh, he's all over it. He's all over it. Yes. You got him on.
Look at that. How good is that? That is just smoking fishing. There must have been a pack of 20. The last three casts have just turned on. He's turned it on. When one won it, they come through, and that is worth flying right across the Tasman for. Quality fishing. Woohoo! Oh, I just looked down and thought I saw mine. Mine's still 100 metres away, Lee, but I could actually see four others just cruising around.
No need to actually lift him out of the water. Just keep him in there.
Mine, yep.
And you're off, mate.
Big one! Oh!
Head and shoulders.
Oh, very crazy. There hasn't been a moment where we haven't been hooked up or landing fish or something. Don't know about you guys, but I'm starting to get a sore arm.
That's that king that came in and nailed the cotton cordell popper on the surface. Beautiful fish, and how good was that take? Yes!
I'm just going to slide him in.
And speaking of surface bites.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah, right, nailed it right there.
How's that? How is that?
And he's just lit up across the top. I just thought, oh yeah, hopefully I'll still be here. Couldn't see a fish. I reckon that lure hit the water, went about 5 feet, and they've just come from nowhere. I don't think I ever want to leave New Zealand.
Let that be a warning to immigration, the people at immigration. We've got a couple of Aussies trying to infiltrate our borders.
I might be around you now.
Okay,
no, but can you feel any rubbing?
Yeah, you think we're all clear?
Can you feel any rubbing?
Please stop that. Please stop that. Well, here we go, I've got colour. I'm tired, my fish is tired, but you can see all of those other fish just following them up. And there's some very, very nice kingfish just sitting in behind them. I'm putting this one just down here, if the camera can pick him up. He's just swimming out of shot now. Probably at around that 15 kilo. This fish here is a little bit smaller, maybe 12 kilo, 10 or 12. We'll bring him in so we can get a decent look at him. Now, this fish come and nailed this jig while it was sitting right on the surface. I mean, hey, how hard could it be? The fish is sitting right here. He's bent that jig. And there we go, that's not a bad fish at all on this spin gear. You'll notice that I've been using on my soft plastics rig a Twin Power 4000. It's a little Shimano spinning reel. Coincidentally, didn't know what gear the guys were going to bring with them. They've got enough gear on this boat to sink a battleship. They've both got the same reels, Twin Power 4000. So I think that says a lot for the quality of this gear. And if what these guys recommend doesn't do it for you, well, just look at what these little reels have just handled. These reels have been lit up the whole time, and those drags have been flawless. Here they come. Oh, here they come.
Big fish.
And I'm gonna let that fella go. I might just chuck a popper on myself, I think, because, hey, they're taking anything, but that popper action on the surface is amazing, and here comes the popper again.
Oh, here they are. All of them shouldering each other.
Oh. Look at them on it. That's unreal.
Oh, look at the head of the
yes. Oh, he's just shaking his head. Oh.
Oh, God. I think he's bigger than what he actually looks.
You reckon?
Yeah.
Look at that.
That is stuck, unless you foul hooked him with a treble hook.
I don't know, he's going.
He's going, mate. Hopefully those trebles can hold out, and we might just get to see just how big that fish is.
How's the action?
How good are those reels just handling all this? This is madness. Madness. That is a good one. That's a real, oh no.
Gone.
Your loss could well be my gain.
I tell you what,
I won't waste any time getting a popper into the water. You'll see there's a bit more action on this popper. And we'll see if they like it just the same.
I got eaten again.
Your popper,
look at that.
He pulled the hook out on his popper. The popper was still down there, sinking in the water.
I thought you busted it.
And he's hooked up.
I just thought I busted off, but it must just be, look at that. Oh no, I got a new fresh one.
Start all over again.
I still have not landed this fish here. Since you've caught two now, Paul. I can't break this fish. There he is.
Oh, look at that, following it right to the boat. Some smaller fish not quite so keen on the big popper, eh?
Oh, he's got it.
He's got it, look at him, he's hooked, he's right there. Of all those fish, that was the smallest one in the pack. You can see him there. Look at some of the horses under him. Look at some of those animals underneath them. And that little cheeky bugger came right in front of all his big mates, and he slammed my popper.
Now this is the fish that took the popper after the other fish let go of the popper, and he's still having a fair crack. This is just incredible fishing. You think that popper was just floating up through the water column. I was just standing there dejected, and another kingy ate it. And he's still got some real stink, this guy.
You won't be dejected for long around here, I don't think.
Oh, look at that. Look at that, I'm missing the back treble. That is how I lost that big king before. And this one has come back and eaten what's almost half a lure, and I've got him. That is unbelievable. I've never pulled the treble out of a popper.
That was a nice fish.
Big fish.
Okay, there's a bigger fish amongst this lot. Here they are.
He took that big slick rig about 10 metres under the boat. Just awesome.
Paulie, what do you do though when you come to New Zealand to catch? Mate, there's some highs in your life. You're about to have your first kid. I'm about to get married to Rach. But
this is better than both of those things.
Sorry, Dale. The kingy, it's up there.
You want me to do that for you there, Paul?
Ah, thanks, mate. Tailed plenty of big kings in my day.
Rightio. Here's your shot. Here's your shot.
Hang on,
make a name for yourself.
I know you can do it.
Oh, I think he's going to get off me.
Don't even mess with that, Paul.
Well, he won't let his mate Paul go.
Don't mess with that one.
Mate, I'm not letting go of this.
Thank you.
That's a thumper.
Yes!
There you go, mate.
What a fish.
Well done. No doubt you're going to want some pickies with that fella.
Absolutely. Shove your hand down there, mate. It'll fit.
Look at that. I'll try and get the flick bait back.
He has swallowed
it. What a fish.
Hello? Hello? Yes? That's a trunk call.
Okay, if it's too deep, fellas, we'll cut it off.
Yeah, that's just there.
Okay, it's away from his gills.
Yeah, nowhere near his gills. There, he's okay. Actually got it.
We don't see any blood. That's beautiful. Look, he has just engulfed that bait.
That's what a fish.
That's plastic. That squidge. That flick bait just brought up through the water column. That is quality. That's a big king. Beautiful.
Yeah. Okay, just one more thing before you slip him back. A research tag. I'm going to pop it in here around the dorsal fin on the same angle. There he goes, tag. That streamer is now in him. If ever you catch a kingfish, or any fish for that matter, with one of these tags in it, follow the instructions on here. You will get a reward, and Lee will know where his kingfish has gone.
Oh.
Look at that. And he's away. Beautiful, well done, mate.
Yes! And it was awesome. So good to be here with some very, very good people. Very, very good friends.
They're going to turn up soon, the good friends.
All right, guys, all right. That there is a popper with no hooks in it. Well, I really am quite exhausted. We've had more than enough action. I can't be bothered winding them in. Take the hooks out of our popper. I get up here, I've got great vision from up on here on top of the hard top, and I'm just cranking that popper in and just doing it for the sheer pleasure of watching these amazing predatory fish smash into the popper, and here they go. Oh, he's on it. Look at them, look at them. Oh man, you've got to see that from up here. I tell you what, Keza, passes that camera, you've got to have a go at this. I've got to get the camera up here so people can see what I am seeing. It is full on. Let's go to a kingfish popper medley. Oh, look at them all. Oh, look at that.
There's some nice ones there. Nice ones.
We're moving to New Zealand, mate.
That fish there was a good 15-20 kilos. That was a nice fish.
How good was that?
Oh, look
at them! Here they come. Look at, oh, there's some bigger ones there. There's some bigger ones there. That fish there was a good 15-20 kilos. That was a nice fish.
That was a nice one, guys.
Oh, look at the head and shoulders.
Yes!
Oh, look at him. Oh, he was angry.
Stay down there, stay down.
Light the fire, boys, light the fire.
Oh, they all turned off. They're all going towards it, the ones over here.
Here they come. Oh, look at them on the top of the gun!
There's a big one there.
Here they come. Look at that.
Come on, that one there.
Yeah. Here they come. Look at, oh, there's some bigger ones there. There's some bigger ones there.
Oh, I just kept coming, mate.
Look, you guys, I did tell you, I warned you.
What?
We're on a tight time schedule, we've got bigger fish to fry.
You only took Lee's nose out. It's not the first that does that.
Yeah. Matt does it his way. Lovely.
After having our journey interrupted by the pack of hungry kingfish, we finally reached Great Barrier Island. What makes this stand out as a fishing destination is the terrain. Miles of rugged, rocky coastline with kelp beds and channels and deep water nearby all adds up to the ideal habitat for big snapper and kingfish. And it was big kingfish that our Australian guests really wanted to hook into. So we headed for the top end of Great Barrier Island to an area known as the Needles that is a favourite hangout for our yellow-tailed friends.
Now we've had a southerly breeze come up. We've found a patch of fish. Now, I mean, look at that there. There is a big pack of fish there. We don't hook up. Oh, hello. And we've hooked up. Oh, that looks like a nicer one too. Oh, double hook up. Go, boys.
Go around, go around. What's that?
A bit of fish. Hold on to them, boys. There's really nasty ground. Oh, busted off. That's what happened when even 80 pound braid meets the bricks. Okay, I'm going to try and steer away. Look out.
If these fish don't bite, there's something wrong.
Hang on, Matt.
Woo, woo, woo. At least 10 kilos of drag on this, at least.
We can get that jig back in.
No worries.
This thing was pulling 10 metre burn.
Oh! Done him?
Yep.
Both big fish.
Both of your doubts, so there's a patch of nice fish there, boys. Woo. What size trace you got?
80.
I've
got 100.
He's got 100.
You got 100?
Look, you're running on the rocks.
Run into your rocks. That's what I said. That's why I was trying to reverse around and rip them off there.
Mate, I haven't been smoked like that
shivers
for a while. That hurt. Let's go again.
Doubt two, boys. Doubt two. You just got bent over and doubt two by a couple of Kiwi kingfish. They're sitting about 20 metres down to the top of the school. Stay with them. Stay with them, mate. Okay, move away from the motors. Move away from the motors. I'm going to get over the top of them. Just put the herbs on and I will get you all. All right, smaller fish or? Smaller fish, mate?
No.
No, no. It's going this way, okay? It's going to concentrate on Paul's fish. Okay, we're moving deeper. We can keep them coming this way. Just try and make the fish relax nice and smooth now. Nice and smooth. We're moving them deeper.
Can I get a belt, please?
Yep.
Nice and smooth, mate.
Oh, it's killing the Christmas crackers.
Oh, no.
My first kid is 6 weeks away. I might be the only one I'm gonna have. We'll keep this up.
Oh. Hold on to it, mate. Hold on to it. We're moving out now. We're in 40 metres of water now. If we can move them off this next pin,
that was
sweet.
That was scary, Lee. It was like being tied to a Jeep. I was doing about 120 kilometres down the highway, and I was tied to the end of it.
I think I did a little bit of weeds. Were you clear of the boat?
Hey?
The line angle clear of the boat? Okay, I'm going to come forward now. I'm going to come forward.
There he is.
Can you see him?
Well, alright. These out the way so I can slip in there and take
them. I just did a little bit of wheeze, Lee.
Oh, that's a big fish, mate. It's serious drag.
Watch him, go for the motors. Hang on, I'll get back on the wheel.
He's up.
He's not
still
going to
have some hands. He's a nice fish. He's a nice fish.
He's a big fish, mate. Well done, Paul. Well done. That's the fish you come to New Zealand to catch, isn't it?
Okay, here we go.
Well done. What a fish. What a fish.
That's a nice kingy.
Well done, Paulie. Well done, Matt. Thanks for making
it
straight on him. He's just going, get him down, boys, get him down.
I tell you what, it's about having the gear and actually using this. Look at the Furuno. We had two drops without a fish. He said, if these fish don't bite, I'll go he. We just got smoked out of control. This guy took me straight down between the E-Tex underneath. I've got a bruise about that big, in the nether region.
Okay, cradle him in your arms.
Get my photo, because that's, mate, that's what we flew from Victoria to catch.
That is what I would call a fair-dinkum Kiwi kingfish. Ready,
mate?
You're the man!
We got him on a benthos jig. It's a 300 grammer, new colour, orange and limo, nice bright colour. It did the trick on that fella.
Nice one. Down a tiny bit, Matt.
What would a fish like this weigh? I'm guessing about 12 to 14 kilos?
Yeah, I would say around 14 kilos, mate. It's got a little bit of depth in it.
Look at that, it's like a big submarine.
There is 30 kilo and bigger models around this area, I happen to know. So you can imagine what those guys like to hang on to.
I reckon this is one of the toughest fish I've ever caught.
Yeah.
For size.
I would say that pulls as hard as a 20 kilo Samson fish.
Oh, absolutely. Now this guy's going back. We love our king, Siriolo Lalandi. We like to look after him. I think he's keen.
And he's
there he goes, straight back to the benthos. Now, Matthew, I normally don't kiss on Thursday.
No! Okay, no more fish for you, mate. That's it.
My turn.
Matt,
Yes.
What a cracker day's fishing. That was just insane. That was
some too shabby.
Biggest fish I've ever seen. But we've got a bit of a problem.
Mate,
a problem?
The stabby craft is very, very nice, but you said sleeping arrangements.
Long way from anywhere.
Yeah, of course. Well, I mean, if you want to find good fishing, you've got to go a long way out. Of course, yeah, a little bit cramped. Don't worry, I've got it covered. Just around the corner, I've got a nice little place. I think you might like it.
Handy, so I'm not sharing a bed with 480.
We're not sleeping, on a rock?
Well, just wait and see, eh?
Okay.
No doubt, it better be good.
After a solid 8 hours of fishing, we had caught and released over 30 kingfish, but we were left with aching arms and an empty stomach. But nestled in a sheltered bay at the back of Great Barrier Island was the answer to our prayers, the luxurious Island Passage. This 5-star, 130-foot mothership was to be our home base for the next 2 days and a launching pad to some of the best fishing New Zealand has to offer. We hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.